From News 8 WMTW-TV, this is a News 8 Now update.
You're watching News 8 Now. I'm Shannon Moss.
I'm Norm Karkos. The trial is set to begin today for a Biddeford man accused of furnishing a place for minors to consume alcohol. On the night, a second-story deck collapsed back in December, sending six people to the hospital with two critical injuries. 40-year-old George Jones was running the apartment at the time, and police say he was present for the party, and his son, who is one of those people injured, was charged with furnishing alcohol to minors. Now, Jones' trial is set to begin this morning in Biddeford District Court. Town leaders in Old Orchard Beach could take a big step today in the rehabilitation efforts for the ballpark. The Lowell All-Americans, who play in the New England College Baseball League along with the Sanford Maiders, want to move to Old Orchard Beach and play 25 home games there next season. Tonight, the town council will vote on whether to approve the letter of intent for the move. Final legal documents would still be needed to approve in the next month. Team officials have proposed paying $10,000 to call the ballpark their home, then splitting concessions revenues with the facility itself.
Well, with fall almost here, there's a little bit of chill in the air. So, of course, thoughts of heating your home come into mind. Man Energy officials say the average cost of a gallon of home heating oil is now $2.50. That's up a penny in the last week. Kerosene running at $2.90 for a gallon, while you'll pay about $2.60 for propane. Those rising costs will no doubt be a burden to those people here in Maine who are struggling, but some help is on the way. Senator Olympia Snowe says Maine is getting nearly $1.4 million in emergency funding for the low-income home energy assistance program, of course better known as LIHEAP. This money is on top of the nearly $60 million already allocated for Maine for this fiscal year. Nearly 50,000 Maine households rely on LIHEAP each year to apply for the money if you need it. Make sure you contact your local community action agency.
Republican Paula Page continues to lead the race to be Maine's next governor, but undecided people could actually still turn the table. That's according to a new poll from Critical Insights. According to the poll, if the election for governor were to be held tomorrow, 38% of the vote would go to LePage, while Democrat Libby Mitchell would get 25%. Independent Elliot Cutler is a distant third with 11% of that vote, while fellow independents Sean Moody and Kevin Scott would receive 4 and 1% respectively. However, 21% of those polled said they're still not decided who they're sure they'll vote for come November 2nd.
Now, if you are one of those undecided voters, or if you just want to hear what the candidates have to say, all five of them will take part in a candidate forum in Waterville today. Event is hosted by the Area Agencies on Aging and will focus on issues facing older Mainers, especially as the baby boomers reach retirement age. Today's forum will run from 10 until 11 this morning at the Spectrum Generations Muskie Community Center on Gold Street in Waterville.
And there are some good news and some bad news when it comes to home foreclosures here in Maine. The State Bureau of Financial Institutions says the number of completed foreclosures dropped in the second quarter. That's based on information from the state chartered banks and credit unions. However, the number of homes in the process of being foreclosed on increased after holding steady in the first quarter. The state says in general, foreclosures in Maine remain lower compared to other states. And that's it for this update. I'm Norm Karkos.
And I'm Shannon Moss. Stay with us. We'll bring the latest forecasts and sports highlights in just a few minutes. We'll be right back.